If you've used Ecamm Live to create a lovely presentation and you're all excited about sending it out to Zoom or MS Teams or a webinar platform, whatever you're using, and then you suddenly realize that it doesn't actually carry the audio, don't worry. In this video, we've got just the solution for you. Let me present Loopback. And this is super easy to set up. If Ecamm offers our virtual camera, then Loopback is our virtual microphone. Think of it that way around. As you can see, you've got two options when you get to the website. There is a trial version and there's an option to buy it. And it's $119 for a one-time license. Now, just to note that this trial version will only give you 20 minutes of clear audio before they play this lovely noise over the top. So while it will give you the opportunity to set this up and just test and make sure that you're happy it works, please remember to go and buy it before you actually do the presentation, because your audience are not going to thank you. So let's show you how to set this up. Assuming you've downloaded that trial or you've bought it, you're going to have this app appear. Open it up and you're going to see this screen, and it's just asking you to set this up. Now, you might find that you've got one already in here at the top. I would click on it and hit the minus and get rid of it and come back to a blank canvas like this. Now, we're going to hit a new virtual device, and I reckon for the sake of consistency, why don't we call this one your virtual mic? It will sit nicely alongside your virtual cam then. Okay, we'll enter that, and don't get confused, there are lots of options and things. You might see Ecamm in the list over here and other things. We're not going to touch any of that. We're just going to leave it as it sits at the minute. So all we've done is literally click add a new device, touch nothing on the settings, renamed it, and now we're going to come back over into Ecamm. So as you can see, I've already got my virtual cam set up over here. I'm assuming you know how to do that. If not, check out this video over here on how to do that. And so what we're doing is click on here to make sure you get the Ecamm Live options. Come across the top, find output, audio monitor, and you're looking for that virtual mic that you just set up. What this is going to do is just gather up all the audio that's going on inside your video and play it out somewhere else. So we can click virtual mic, and as you can see straight away over here on Loopback, it's picking that up and it's sending it out. So if I were to play a video over here, so maybe this is my welcome video, I'm going to press play on here and notice that over on Loopback you're going to see it still coming through. If I want to run a pre-recorded video, I've got a testimonial here.
Hello, my name is Darren Lee and I've just completed the setup part of the pro video.
And so you can see that that is now coming through. So that's gathered up the audio. Now we need to send it out, and we're just going to use Zoom in this example, but this could be the same in MS Teams or your webinar platform. So when you open up Zoom, you don't need to go into your meeting itself. You can come over here to these settings, and so under video, you've got your Ecamm virtual cam that is feeding through. And so again, when I play that intro video, that's coming out into Zoom. And now for the audio, look, there's our virtual mic. And as you can see, the audio is coming in. Again, let me just demo that by playing the video. So you can absolutely see that that feed is coming in. So that's us with our settings done. I could now open up a meeting. So now I'm in my meeting, and again, just to double check, Ecamm virtual cam is selected under the video. You could just come straight into this if you wanted without going into the preferences. And in the microphone, select your microphone. We've got virtual mic instead of what would normally be my cam link. So we're all set and we're good to go. In theory, if I wanted to, I could just head off with this Zoom presentation and almost minimize this while I'm working up here in Ecamm and running through my videos and things.
Hello, my name is Darren Lee and I've just completed.
How cool is that? So now the video's coming through, the audio's coming through, we've just solved that big headache for you. Now, one tip, and this is nothing to do with Zoom or any other application, this is purely to do with your presentation, but I've seen it done so many times that I just feel I need to spell this out to you. It's really important to have this sound levels tab open and use it. Now, you can see on here at the minute that this is my microphone coming in, and it's just in the green there, It could be just touching into the yellow. I could set it up here, but keep your eye on it. I do not want this up high so that it's hitting in the reds and it's too loud. But the point of this tip is make sure that when you're playing a video or something, you're keeping it to a consistent level, a consistent volume for your audience. So if I've chosen to have this one set that it's just occasionally peaking into the yellow, but it's mostly in the green, I wanna make sure that when I play my video, it's doing exactly the same. So let's click this testimonial and notice on the line below, we're gonna see the audio for that.
Hello, my name is Darren Lee, and I've just completed the setup part of the Pro Video Academy course. And it's absolutely amazing how Adrian has made this step-by-step super simple. He literally says, find this camera setting and change it to this. Find that camera setting and change it to that. And within minutes, I had my professional look set up.
So as you can see, I've just set that up now. I had to just adjust that a little bit. But what would have happened otherwise is I'd have been talking and then I'd have played this video. And my audience are going, oh, he's a bit quiet. And they turn the volume up and then I come back on and I'm loud and then they're turning the volume down again. Now, one of the ways that this drives me mad is when you're playing sound effects or something over the top of it. Exactly the same thing happens with sound effects. If you decide you want to play an applause or something like that in the middle of your video, this is actually muted at the minute. Do make sure that that is at its maximum, it's hitting the same, but I would tone it down a bit. I don't want, as I'm talking, for the sound effect to, oh, just scare my audience because they're sitting listening to it. Especially if you're gonna go with one of these air horns or something. That's a shocking noise anyway, but if that comes on full volume. So I really recommend that you use these levels before you do your presentation and make sure that everything is balanced and looking right. Better still, why don't you do as I've got here, a record only, set that recording, just quickly, you don't have to go through the full length of it, but just jump through your scenes and make sure you're happy with it. Play it back to yourself and go, yep, did that all sound about right? It can make a huge difference. You've gone to a lot of work to put a presentation together. You've bought Loopback, you've set all this up, and that one little thing can really annoy those that are watching. Really recommend that you just take that bit of extra time to run through it and check that those levels are all right. Okay, so that's Loopback. Go have some fun with it. As I say, by all means, use the trial version and just set this up. If you wanted to do this little record only, you could do the recording in Zoom so that you can see that it is coming through and actually doing what you want it to. And then when you're happy with it, it'll give you an option to just go off and buy the full version. So hopefully that solved this issue for you. I told you it was easy. We would love to hear from you what you think to it and how you're getting on with it. And if you've got questions or something comes up that we haven't covered, let us know in the comments and we'll come back to you. All right, thanks so much. See you in another video.